Hey guys, welcome back to another vectors lesson. I'm determined to go through as much of this as possible, so don't be surprised if we get up to, I don't know, lesson 20 or 30 or something like that. So hopefully you guys have been understanding everything that I've been saying. Anytime you feel like you need a bit of help, make sure you let me know via a message or a comment. Okay, so the first thing I want to do today is define a problem. So the question is, consider the vector u, which has a magnitude of 20 and a bearing of 200 degrees true. Express the vector's position in terms of I and j. So basically, we're giving you a vector, but without the x and the y coordinates, for I and j, and we want you to find it. So let's draw the vector first. So obviously we're only going to sketch this. So we have the y-axis, the x-axis, and the magnitude is 20 and a bearing of 200. So you can consider this the north. Okay, so it's the north here, and 200 degrees, so we got 90 degrees up to here, and then another 90 degrees up to here, so this is 180 degrees, and then another 20 degrees down here. Okay, so this is 20 degrees, and the magnitude of this vector is 20. So if this is vector u, okay, the magnitude of vector u is 20. Okay, so let's firstly draw our right angle triangle to the horizontal. Okay, so this is our right angle triangle, and let me isolate that triangle by getting rid of everything around it. So I have a right angle here, I have u here, which is 20. Okay, and I'm looking for the y-axis and the x-axis. Okay, so how do we find this? Well, we already know what this angle is, don't we? Right, because theta is 70 degrees. Right, because this angle here is 20, which means this angle here must be 70. Okay, so if this angle is 70 and we want to find y, then we can just use a bit of trigonometry. So this is the opposite side and that's the adjacent side. So and this is the hypotenuse, and using the trigonometry Sokatoa, so you probably need to make sure that you know trigonometry before you do this. So we're using the hypotenuse, finding the opposite. So sine theta equals opposite over hypotenuse. Sine 20 equals opposite over 20. Sorry, not 20. The angle is 70. I should just write 70 here so I don't get confused. So this angle here is 70. Okay. So sine 70 equals opposite over 20. So opposite equals 20 times sine 70, and if you put that in your calculator, and the answer is 18.8 units. Okay, 18.8 units. So let's do the similar thing with x. So actually I should have substituted y into that equation just so that people don't get mixed up between So we got y, so y equals 18.8 units. And now we want to find x. So we've got the hypotenuse. We're going to use cosine theta equals a over h. So cos 70 equals x over 20. So x equals 20 cos 70. And the answer is, type that in your calculator. So 20 times cos 70, and the answer is 6.84. Okay, so we have found the x and the y components of this vector. So if we write it as a position vector, we can therefore say vector u is x times I plus y times j. Okay, what's that circle doing there? Let's get rid of that. So therefore vector u is equal to 6.84 i plus 18.8 j. Okay, now does this work for this? No, because the vector is going in this direction. So therefore we need to realize that x is negative and y is negative. So therefore we need to change this to negative 6.84 i plus negative 18.8 j. Okay, make sure you get the negative numbers in. Okay, now if you want to check whether you have done this right, you can always put these numbers into your magnitude formula again. So the magnitude is equal to square root of x squared plus y squared. So that's 6.84 squared plus 18.8 squared. You can put the negative sign in there if you want, it'll just give you the same thing. So let's put that in our calculator. Squared, where is the squared button? Plus 18.8 squared. Okay, 200, 400, and if we square root that, it's about 20. So it's about 20, which is correct because we have rounded this. Okay, we have rounded these numbers here, which doesn't make the answer exact. But that's how you do it. Okay, so hopefully you guys understand how to find the position vector given a magnitude and the bearing of a vector.